Now we have wefox on stage, and Target, and Allianz. And Edwin is replacing Nassim from Allianz, who had an urgent travel. Then, of course, we have Yaron from Target. When did you invest in wefox again?
When did I invest in wefox, Julian?
That was 2016, 2 years ago, yeah. And it was definitely too cheap.
Too cheap. And then we have Julian, as you can see, he's the founder and the CEO. Now, before we go into the discussion between the champions and the challengers, I think we all know what Allianz is, but maybe Julian, you can give us a quick overview about wefox. How old is the company? What problem are you solving, and how is it going?
So essentially, it's a three-year-old company. We have figured out on how to grow to a critical mass of customers by providing a tech solution for insurance brokers. So insurance brokers...
To provide what?
Insurance brokers.
A tech
solution for insurance brokers.
A tech solution. Okay.
Insurance brokers are the largest distribution channel in the world for insurance. 50% of all insurance premia is sold by the insurance broker. Mm-hmm. And they have no type of technology to manage their customers.
And this 50% is in Germany or
it's global.
Switzerland?
Global. It's global. So we have 15 million agents. We have 3 billion customer relationships with brokers that have no technology. So this is what we're providing. So we've grown to more than 1,000 brokers that manage their 250,000 customers on a digital interface and double their revenue after 12 months with our technology. We're now on a revenue run rate of 50 million this year, 400% increase. And we just launched our own insurance company on top of that marketplace, working with more than 300 old companies, but have also now started our own player called One, plugged it into the marketplace of wefox, and growing around 20x faster than Lemonade, live 3 months.
Mark, wow. You see why I fell in love with this gentleman?
Sorry?
You see why I fell in love with him?
I don't fall in love.
I did.
Now,
I fall in love with all my entrepreneurs.
So there was this Swiss startup, Knips, or something like this, right? And they had something very naughty done. I think when you set up your account, and I think the value proposition for the consumer was you see all your insurance contracts at one spot, right? And that's kind of nice. It makes sense. But when you click the box or when you set up your account, what happened, you actually changed your insurance broker without you knowing to Knips, and there was a huge drama in the industry, and I think 70% of the customers who became Knips customers churned. Your focus on the brokers, is that the logical pivoting of what Knips did wrong?
Yeah, it's a kind of second mover advantage. Yeah, our churn is 0.1 or something like this. Yeah, basically no churn. And the broker brings around 300 customers onto our platform and grows his customer base to around 2,400.
So you are like the Farfetch of the insurance industry, empowering the brokers and making sure they have a future existence. So Edwin, Allianz, I think you're the largest insurance company in the world, is
yes,
that right?
Depending on how you look at it. And I mean, going back to Allianz and Allianz X and what Allianz X is doing is, listen, we understand that the insurance industry is changing. There are disruptors. I mean, I'm sitting next to a disruptor right here. And Allianz X is here to work with that disruption. That's why what Allianz X is doing, we're investing in digital growth companies within the insurance space. We understand that insurance is changing. The needs of the customers are changing. And we want to better serve those customers' needs, and that's why I'm part of Allianz X.
Do you like your brokers?
I'm sorry?
Do you like your brokers? I mean, look, we are in digital. Why don't you go direct to the consumer? Why do you need brokers at all?
We have a very strong distribution channel, a variety of different distributors, and we value those relationships. And we want to work with technology companies to strengthen those relationships.
So some people may need face-to-face advice,
absolutely.
Maybe the older generations, and the younger ones are using the Facilis and the Check24s and Money Supermarkets. I'm sure it's not a number you have disclosed before, but maybe you can give us an indication. If you look at the traditional distribution on the broker side versus the platforms, is it now like a 50-50? I mean, for car insurances in the UK, I heard that 70-80% is going already through the platforms. Some other markets like Germany, Italy are more around 30%. Can you tell us a little bit how important the brokers are versus the platforms?
Absolutely, and guys, feel free to chime in here too. Again though, Allianz is focused on customer centricity. And the different distribution channels, I mean, they're changing, they're improving, but again, we highly value our distribution networks that we have now, and we feel that we can lever technology to improve those distribution channels, to improve our relationships, and more so, most importantly, improve our relationship with our customer base.
I can tell you one thing. 10 years ago, direct distribution and insurance was around 9% if you look at premium. All the experts said it's going to double in the next 10 years. Today, it's still at 9%. It's not growing. The only channel that's really growing premium-wise is the broker. And the reason is insurance, you cannot compare to other products. It's an abstract product. And if you bring the example of car, that's one of the only products where there's a pull component, okay? So you don't want an insurance. You want to drive a car, right? And that's the difference. All of the push products, the human continues to stay the most important distributor for a long period of time. The complexity of the products will not disappear from one day to the next. And today we have 21 billion active paper policies on our planet. And they will not dissolve from one day to the next.
So you're bringing those 21 million, billion?
Billion.
Billion, oof. Same number like Visa told us about the, no, that's trillions. So big numbers. What's the split? What type of insurance? You said car insurances are easier to go through the platforms because they're easy to compare and you don't really want them. But on the more complex insurance side, the broker is needed. What is your insurance split, the ones you have on your platform?
So basically, our value proposition to the customer is a single point of contact for everything, yeah. Right? So we're also serving the pull products, right? Because there is an advantage of having everything in one overview. But the real value of the consultation of with the broker is, of course, let's look at my retirement. Let's look at my health coverage. Let's look at more complex, really serious things, right?
Health insurance, life insurance,
disability.
And the people who download your app and sign up, they stay with their broker, usually, or do they change the broker?
They stay with their broker.
They stay with their
broker. It's a one-to-one relationship. Yeah.
So how global or how international are you? I think the company was set up in Switzerland originally also. Yeah. There is a Swiss original link. But how international you are, and is that an easy way for you to grow?
So we're with wefox, we're in Switzerland, Germany, Austria, going live in 5 further countries in Europe this year. And with our own insurance company, we have a license for the biggest insurance market in the world, which is the European Union. So that's a great thing about Europe and the EU. You have a license in one country, and you can distribute your product all across 27 countries.
Right. So Edwin, this all sounds great, right? It's like the emancipation of the brokers, which we all thought they're getting disrupted. You call them a disruptor. I don't think they're a disruptor. They're basically some smart insurance tech company who is basically making sure that the industry structure is not going completely to platforms like the Check24s.
Yep.
Do you give them any help? You're not invested, you don't have a commercial alliance, but thinking about kind of the industry, you should have an interest that your brokers digitize and working with them is also easier from an integration point of view.
Absolutely. I think that one of the themes that I have noticed at this NOAH conference is really the importance of the more traditional companies, the established companies, working with the new entrants, working with the insurtechs. I mean, it's of absolute utmost importance. We can really learn from each other, and I think that's something that I know Allianz welcomes. So
and we
we're
actually
looking
work with
to
them,
that.
Right? So they're one of the 300 insurance companies, and we're generating more and more revenue for you guys and a strong partnership here.
Yeah. Are you worried about peer-to-peer insurances, like on the private level?
I mean,
it sounds nice in theory, but is there like any big player globally who got this part of the business to work?
I don't know. What do you think? You're probably better.
P-
peer to
peer. Yeah, you get so many deals.
Yeah. Right, we see, you know, we see a tremendous amount of deals in the insurance space, and you know, we're great believers in this space. I'm also an investor in the previous company that presented here, but on a personal level, the disruption in this space is amazing. But I think the disruption, it's a very traditional market. It's a market that deals with something that is very important to all of us and is very very sensitive to all of us. The likelihood, the traditional structures will completely break, whether it's the whether it's who insures you or whether it's who you have a relationship with or whether it's your agent or whether it's your insurance company. I don't think that these structures will just break.
Okay.
They will adapt.
Yeah, it's a big industry, and there's one thing I don't want to think of. Insurance, because it's usually a hassle. Do you help with the claim management?
Of course, yeah.
Is that a core aspect of your business?
Of course, you have the wefox app as a customer, you have all of your policies in there, you click on it, you manage your claim, we take care of everything, you don't have to worry about it. And at one, if you have a claim, you actually have a chatbot, and 60% of the claims are paid out instantly.
That's a reason to sign up.
Yeah, so all of you please download the app and sign up.
So it's kind of comfort having everything at one place, and then when something goes wrong in your life, you can go through the app and get compensated, which is the side of the business.
We know you don't like insurance, so we try to make it as simple as possible for you.
Well, excellent. Thank you so much. Great, lovely panel.
Thank you.
Julian, thank you. Thanks. Yaron, Edward, good luck. Thank you for being here.